Hey Linux Explorers, welcome back to Fix My Linux, where we solve Linux issues one fix at a time.
In today's video, I'll walk you through the process of accessing a shared folder from Windows 11 on a Linux system, specifically Ubuntu, but this works on other distros too. Let's get started. First, log into your Linux machine with your username and password. Now let's check the IP address of the Linux system using the following command, hostname-inext. Log into your Windows 11 machine. Again, make sure both systems are connected to the same LAN. They must be on the same network to talk to each other. Once you're on the Windows system, open a command prompt and run ipconfig. This gives you the IP address of your Windows machine. Now, let's create a folder to share. It's best to create it somewhere other than the C drive. I'm placing it in the D drive and naming it Windows Share. You can name it whatever you like. Right-click the folder, go to Properties and switch to the Sharing tab, click the Share button. From the drop-down, select Everyone, then click Add. Once added, click the Share button. Windows may prompt you with a network discovery message. Choose the first option. No, make the network I am connected to a private network. Now take note of the shared folder address that appears. It usually starts with two backslashes. Back on the Ubuntu system, we'll need to install a package to access Windows Shares. That's Samba. Open a terminal and run. Sudo apt install Samba. Approve the installation by pressing Y when prompted. Once installed, check the status of the Samba service, sudo service smbd status. If it shows active, then you're good to go. Now open the file manager on Ubuntu and click Other Locations. At the bottom in the Connect to Server field, type in the path using this format, smb://username@ip-address/windows-share. Replace username, IP address, and Windows Share with your actual details. Click Connect. And when prompted, enter your Windows credentials. Once connected, you'll be able to browse the contents of your shared folder from Ubuntu. Let's test it out. Go back to your Windows system and create a simple text file inside the shared folder. Write something in it so we can verify if the content is accessible from Ubuntu. Switch back to Ubuntu and refresh the shared folder view. And there it is, the newly created file, fully accessible. To make access easier in the future, bookmark the shared folder so you won't need to type the connection details again. But what happens after a reboot? Let's restart the Ubuntu system and see what happens. After reboot, click on the bookmarked folder. You'll notice that it asks for your password again. The fix is simple. Enter your credentials, check the Remember Forever option at the bottom of the window, and click Connect. Now restart Ubuntu again. This time when you open the shared folder, it logs you in automatically. No password prompt. This is thanks to Ubuntu's keyring saving your credentials. One last thing, make sure your Windows system has a static IP address assigned. If the IP changes, your bookmark will no longer work. And that's it. You've successfully configured file sharing between Windows and Ubuntu using Samba. Now you can seamlessly move files between the two systems. No USB drives, no email attachments, just fast and direct sharing over your local network. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more Linux tips and tricks. Thanks for watching.